those of us who understand science, who have been part of how it works, and who have seen it at its most essential levels, we understand that it has all of the hallmark diseases of religion. Science is nepotistic. It's all bullshit. It's all about who you know and whose cock you're stroking. Who are you greasing your palms for? Who's your dirty back door? That's all it is. All of who gets published, who gets listened to, why did you get a book deal? Why did you get tenure? Why did you make it to a PhD program when someone else didn't? It starts at the junior level. It goes straight up through the ranks, all the way. It's all a big sorority, fraternity, underwear party. You understand this or not, doesn't matter. But that's the truth of it. It's all a secret society. It's all one big closed web that says, we know everything and we're not sharing. That's how it is. It's a club. It's a group. It's a group. And it follows authority. It follows leadership. It's a social group. You're naked chimpanzees. You're all naked chimpanzees with really cool stuff. So you know how your systems work. The best thing for you has been always freedom, freedom, freedom. But universities don't have freedom. There's no such thing as academic freedom. I just went through it. I experienced it fully. There is no academic freedom. You don't have the choice to do what you want. You don't have the choice to do what you want. You don't. You don't. You're never given it. You're given options every once in a while to kind of do something that they define for you, mostly. The students of today aren't allowed to think, and most of them are so much smarter than the people who are pulling their reins, controlling them. Those of you who would be truly, truly, truly part of the educational process have to know how it really, really, really works. I have gone to the hallowed house of learning here. This is Mecca for that. This is where it all goes down, baby. I've been there. I've seen it. It's all the same joke. It's all the same big chest beating and waving sticks around. Who cares? Fine. If you're going to be that way, fine. But why not let it be free? You don't have alphas because you don't allow them to rise to the top. You've created systems where they become closed. It's not generative. That's why you have bad teachers. They were able to sleep on enough casting couches to get their tenure. And finally, after they went under every bar and jumped through every hoop and put off every dream they ever had, and they're so bitter and bored and old and tired and hateful of the entire learning process, they finally, have supposed academic freedom, and they could say whatever they want, and they don't have anything left to say. And they're too afraid to lose their tenure if they did. The people who come up with the new stuff are always the ones who get pushed away to the side. So you want to look for the good stuff, you got to go look at the side. You got to go look at the fringe, look at the edge, look at the salt. Look at Zimbabwe, you know, go to shanty towns outside of South Africa, and you're going to find human beings who, without embodied capital, have risen. And yeah, they're going to be less frequent, but they're going to burn so much better and brighter. Because they're going to know how to embody their own capital. Until we allow our students and ourselves as educators and as priests and as parishioners and as people, as students, as children, as parents, as everything we do, as leaders, as authorities, as everything, if we cannot be free, then we can't do it. You have to be able to follow your heart and do what you know is right. And if you always have some rule that says you can't, you have to do what the paperwork says. You have to follow the line. You have to follow the letter of the law. If you do it that way, you're not going to fix anything. Science, people.